struck by a quote from the HR director of the district when he said that the depth of the brokenness of the Kansas City School District was surprising.
What's critical at this juncture is to recognize that in order for us to have the hope of a transformed Kansas City, Missouri school district,
we need to have some fundamental change in the way the school, that different from what the school district has had in the past.
If our students graduate from a non-accredited school, then it may cause an issue with acceptance at many colleges.
Our district has been and is severely broken.
People talk about white flight. What is frequently forgotten is that anyone who had the means was able to leave, and many did, white and otherwise. Part of the reason white flight, I think, is very appropriately given the majority of the blame is because, unlike everyone else, the white flight was actually sponsored by the federal government. And so when you have specific redlining practices by government and private agencies that provide loans and opportunities for white families, but not for other families, what you have is state-sponsored racism. And yes, today we live with the remnants of state-sponsored racism here in the urban core.
We used to have students who live in Liberty, all over the Kansas City area, and we had taxi cabs to bring them here. That was another initiative.
What happened was there was a desegregation case, and the judge allowed the community to spend whatever it needed to spend in order to desegregate the district, a very different strategy than to spend whatever it needs to spend to turn the district around.
It was an initiative to integrate the schools and to bring students together, you know, to help achievement.
The intention of those $2 billion wasn't to improve student achievement directly. The direct intention of those $2 billion was to desegregate the district. There were those who believed that desegregating the district would increase student achievement.
But we're actually busing kids into Caucasian kids, and that was a criteria. You know, that you had to be a Caucasian in order to come to be the taxi cab to be paid for to come to our schools.
Desegregation based on racial terms, in my opinion, was never going to be a solution for increasing student achievement, and in fact could easily be seen in a very condescending light.
So we did that for a short term, and it was very costly and didn't work that well.
And so even though that has been the history of this district, and even though there was a great deal of desegregation efforts that tried to counteract that history, and those too failed, all there is that remains for us today is to recommit ourselves to the task of ensuring that we are doing everything we can do not to replicate the folly of the past.
This is a summary of some of our research. We've heard some people say the district is broken. It cannot be changed, just throw it away and start all over again. The district is too divided.
What we kept hearing was that people were concerned about the Kansas City, Missouri schools. Huh? We kept avoiding taking that on as an issue because it's so huge. There's so many people have tried to make changes, and you know, we're not really educational experts. Eventually, we said, you know, we're probably going to have to, like, focus on schools somehow.
A lack of stability. 22 superintendents since 1969.
We thought, well, that's maybe we better go out and ask the people why they think we should be focusing on the schools. One is they felt that it was a social justice issue, that, you know, that kids should have the opportunity to go to good schools so that they would have a good education. The second thing was that we were losing neighbors when the kid was getting to the age of high school. would leave and go to Johnson County, that's moved down the age group now. They leave when the kid's ready to go to school, huh?
A loss of students, 75,000 in 1975 to 16,800 today.
And, you know, the neighborhoods, you know, we would like for our school district to rank, like, you know, Shawnee Mission, you know, all the Overland Park schools. We should be at the same level.
Now we must find a new way. And if we don't, then the consequences from the state will be dire. If it became evident that it was in the best interest of the scholars of this district for the state to take over and to remove the school board, I would most certainly herald the coming of such a plan.
It worried me that some of our teachers would end up getting removed from our faculty, because that's what keeps a lot of students going. I know it's a lot of teachers here who helped me keep going, who pushed me and drive me, and I know that if they got taken away, I probably wouldn't be as motivated as I am.
The school district has to regain its accreditation. So there's a two-year program that's ongoing, which has to be done and has to be, you know, implemented. And if it's not, the state will take over the school district. Huh?
I understand and even sympathize with the ideas of those who see a takeover or an appointed board as a panacea, but recognize that research suggests that neither would be so.
The people said, you know, we expect our taxes to be well used, and we have questions as to whether they really are.
We have not done a very good job of accountability. I mean, we have squandered more dollars in this school district than I even care to even talk about. But that is going to change. I searched across the length and breadth of this nation to put together a leadership team that could come to us and do the heavy lifting, if you will, that need to be done to make sure that our children are receiving the kind of education where they can acquire the knowledge, the competence, and skill that they might become fierce competitors on the economic world stage.
What's critical at this juncture is to recognize that in order for us to have the hope of a transformed Kansas City, Missouri school district, we need a 10-year superintendent. Dr. Covington is that 10-year superintendent. What that means is for us, the community and the board, to figure out how to work cooperatively, collaboratively, to make this work.
Without question, it is going to take this level of interest, this level of concern on the part of the citizens of Kansas City to turn the tide and change the public schools once and for all in the Kansas City, Missouri School District. Thank you so very much for being here. I appreciate it.